Well, now those overnight storms meant early morning cleanups for residents across Kansas. KCTV5's Marcel Clark spoke to several homeowners in the affected areas.
We checked out some of the areas that saw the damage firsthand. Some already had cleanup crews by the time we got there, while others had KCP&L crews working on power outages. All the people we spoke to agreed it was a noisy night.
Just heard all the high winds, looked out and had three trees in our yard down, two uprooted, one just fell on their deck, and thankfully we're all safe.
We just had high winds and turned on the television and the sirens went off. So I was just by myself, and so I took our dog and cat to the basement.
This is what people living near 133rd and Mission had to say after they missed several hours of sleep due to Mother Nature's roar. Just 10 minutes near that location, the residents near the intersection of Metcalf and 135th also had trouble sleeping.
It does seem really real. I mean, especially when we grew up watching those movies, tornado movies like Twister. All of a sudden, we're in the midst of it and seeing the TV, how the tornado moves so fast. So wasn't an experience, yeah.
One man says he wasn't worried, but had to look over his wife.
She was definitely concerned. It's her first Kansas storm.
These two areas mainly experienced a lot of debris and broken down trees. People near Mission Road did see several power outages, which affected more than 9,000 customers overnight. We did ask people today if they were concerned for tonight's storm.
Not at all.
It's Kansas and we had some high winds, so I think the school here at Mission Trail is happy to have a day off.
Well, I was not even aware of it.
Definitely a lot of mixed reactions. The two counties that saw the most damage were Johnson County, Kansas, and Jackson County. Marcel Clark, KCTV 5 News.